My name's John Gerard Fagan, and I'm the author of Fishtown. So I'm from a wee town called Muirhead in the outskirts of Glasgow, and I was in a rut. By the time I was in my late 20s, I'd been in a constant loop of unemployment and temporary work, and I didn't see anything changing, and nothing had for a number of years. So I was looking for a way out, and I found that in Japan. I seen a job in Japan, and I thought, you know what? I'm going to go for it. I sold everything I had, I packed my bag, and I bought a one-way ticket, and I went into the unknown. And that's where this book comes from. When people think of Japan, they think of beautiful mountains like Mount Fuji, and cherry blossom trees that are lining all the streets, and sushi places in every corner, little temples and little shrines, and big cities as well, like Tokyo and Osaka, full of neon lights. And you would also find monuments to Godzilla everywhere. Is this true? Yeah, it is true. Japan is like that, but there's a lot more to it when you're actually living there rather than just going there on holiday. If you go there for a two-week holiday, you'll see all these things, but under the surface, there's a little bit more to it. They have lots of festivals, which are beautiful, and Japan is full of some of the most beautiful scenery in the world. Every town has their own little festival where they all get dressed up and they wear their uniforms and they all get drunk and they sing songs and they play the drums and everybody's happy. And it's a really beautiful thing to see. And also they've got things like fire throwing festivals where you can get fireballs and you've got a little hard hat and you're just constantly throwing these fireballs to try and light a big one up the top. It's crazy, but it's something that's really cool to do. And as I said, if you went there on a holiday trip, you could do this or be part of this and you come back with a great experience. But there is more to Japan. I would say it's equal parts fascinating, intriguing, but also absurd as well. The book, Fishtown, is about my life there in Japan from 2013 onwards. I would say it's a travel book, but it's more than just traveling, it's living there. So it's about many things. One of the most important things I would say it's about friendships. The friendships you make there are going to be more intense because you're by yourself and they're by themselves and you've got no one else to rely on. So that's something that you have to get right at the start. If you get lucky and you make good friends, you've done well. If you don't, it's going to be a lot harder. The language there as well is very difficult. So it helps if you've got someone that can speak the same language as you. Japan has got three different alphabets that are all very unique and different. So I didn't really know this before I went. So it's something that I had to get a hang on. Otherwise, I would get lost very quickly with everything that was over there. So it's about friendships. It's also about falling in love. And it's also about loneliness. Loneliness is a big thing when you're moving abroad and especially going to Japan from Asia, from Scotland. It was very, very different and it was something that affected me, but it's something that I powered through. It was hard going at times, but that was to be expected. If you're going to move abroad, it's not all going to be plain sailing. So the book covers that. But I think most of all, it's about adventure. It's about going into the wild, leaving everything behind, jumping down the rabbit hole and seeing what's on the other side. When I first got there, I thought I was going to Tokyo. I thought I was going to a big neon city that I could spend the weekends going out and getting drunk all the time, as you do when you're in your late 20s. That's what I thought a life would be. Good coming from a small town in Scotland, got out like that. That was a good opportunity for me. So I thought I'd be able to be in the big city and that'd be great. And that's what I got told in the interview that I was going to be near there. So I was excited about that. But when I got there, I found out I was going to be in a little fishing town. So it was miles away from anywhere. There was empty roads and there was hardly anyone that could speak any English. And bearing in mind, that's kind of my fault because I didn't know any Japanese going there. But I expected a little bit that people could understand even a little bit, but they didn't. So that was difficult and that was very isolating. So that's where the book starts, when I got put into Fishtown. Even the schools there, because I went to be an English teacher, I thought I could use my creative writing that I studied, that I could teach some different stories, and it'd be a good experience for help me progress with them as well. But a lot of the schools, they had backwards technology for the time. You think of Japan, you think of all this cool futuristic technology. They had hardly anything. They had squat toilets, and they didn't even have hot water, most of them. So it was very different from what I thought it was going to be. But that was a life, and I got on with it. It was that, do I give up and go back to Scotland and try and get a job again? Or do I just power through this and see what happens? And yeah, I chose the second option. I chose, you know what, I'm going to try and make the most of it, even though it's not what I expected and I'm underprepared. I thought, I'll go for it. So my little flat was a one-bedroom flat that was right next to a fish factory. And that was an eye-opener. Couldn't really open the window because that's all I could smell. It's not all positive, but it's not all negative. It's a mixture, and the book undercovers that and shows the different sides to Japan, especially as a foreigner when you're living there. Why did I write this book? It's a question that people ask. I think it was to make sense of the 7 years that I was there, to put a full stop on it. I started writing it on the last day in Japan, just to like get my thoughts about how I was feeling. So I was waiting on the plane to leave, and I got out my phone, and in notes I just started to write what I was feeling at the time. I didn't think I'd write a memoir. That wasn't my plan. I just thought, I'll get down my ideas because I'm probably going to forget things. And there was so much that happened that I thought, it's best to get this down just for myself. I didn't keep a diary or nothing. But the more I told the stories, the more people found them interesting. The more I thought, you know what, I might have something here. I decided after a year of writing down little memories that I put it in some sort of structure, made it into a book and sent it off. And yeah, it's getting published. It's a book that I'm proud of, but it's personal. So my other fiction, you can let it go and that's it, doesn't really matter. But this is a personal story. So it's a little bit, it brings with it anxiety because it's something personal that you're putting out there and people are going to judge the story. You're not a character, you're a real person. It's something that I'm willing to take and hopefully people like it and they can take something out of it. I'm not saying this is a guidebook. I'm not going to say that this is what you should do if you're going to live abroad. But people, they might take something out of it that's positive and they might not be as underprepared as I was if they're going to live in Asia, especially in a country like Japan. And that might be more common now because of what's happened with Brexit and what's happened with the virus, that people are going to be losing their jobs and they might have to go abroad. So it might help people at that. But I think it'll appeal to people who like adventure stories as well. If you can get some sort of escapism from your life for doing this, then yeah, I think that'll be positive for people that like that. If that sounds like something you'd be interested in reading, then I think you should buy the book. It's going to be out on the 28th of April by Guts Publishing. You can follow me on Twitter at JohnGerrydFagan for more details about it and for updates. Thank you very much.